Queen Elizabeth II. Like her namesake, Queen Elizabeth I, did not pass her childhood in any certain expectation of the crown. This new Elizabethan age comes at a time when mankind stands uncertainly poised.
Wait.
On the edge of catastrophe.
The reign of Queen Elizabeth II has been and still is one of the most important times in history. She became Queen of the United Kingdom in 1952 at the age of 25 after her father, King George VI, died while she was on a royal tour. In 2007, she was named the longest living monarch and queen, surpassing her great-great-grandmother, Queen Victoria, whose reign lasted for 64 years from 1837 to 1901. The Netflix series titled The Crown was created by Peter Morgan and launched its first season in 2016. He ironically produced the film The Queen 10 years prior, starring Helen Mirren as the Queen herself and Michael Sheen as Prime Minister Tony Blair. However, this film only covered the Queen's point of view of the events that took place after the death of Diana Spencer, the then titled Princess of Wales, in 1998. Meanwhile, The Crown displays the events that led up to and happened after the Queen's sudden coronation. This video essay will cover the accuracy between the series and the real-life events that inspire them in terms of cinematic elements, particularly the narrative and the mise-en-scene, as I felt these were the most detailed features of the production. The series begins with a change of titles of Prince Philip Mountbatten, renouncing his title as Prince of Greece and of Denmark to become Duke of Edinburgh in 1947, followed by his marriage to then-titled Princess Elizabeth in the same year. As the series progressed, viewers were presented with a great deal of events after the Queen's coronation in 1953. From the scandal between Princess Margaret and group captain Peter Townsend in the same year, to the brutal and toxic marriage between Prince and Princess of Wales, Charles and Diana, between the 1980s and the 1990s, as shown in the most recent season of the series, which was released in the fall of 2020. The series then has received praise and gained many fans among the years. Some articles stated that even the Queen herself enjoyed the first season of the show. Others beg to differ, as the series was also criticized by some viewers of becoming more inaccurate with each season. One example comes from the first episode of season 3 titled The Olding. During and after Winston Churchill's funeral in 1964, a CIA agent from the United States informs the Director General at the MI5 headquarters in London that there is a mole from the KGB among British officials. Characters of the show, including the Queen and perhaps the audience, began to suspect the Prime Minister Harold Wilson, who was in office at the time. However, we learn that this is not true, even though the KGB did make numerous attempts to recruit Wilson, as he did travel to Russia often for trade missions in the past. Another rumor is that he poisoned Hugh Gaitskill. The opposition leader actually died of lupus in 1963. The mole was actually Sir Anthony Blunt, an art historian and the surveyor of the Queen's pictures at the time. This information is accurately true. What was inaccurate about these events is what happened after the information surfaced. At the end of the episode, the Duke of Edinburgh confronts Blunt about the truth and tells him he will lock him away, to which Blunt blackmails him if he does. The accuracy of this confrontation, though, is to be determined. Meanwhile, the end card details were accurate, but some facts were left out. The show did not mention the fact that the tapes of Blunt's confession were released in 1979, 7 years after his retirement, and the knighthood he received in 1956 was taken away. Another important portion of the production that kept the accuracy between the series and the history of the royal family was the mise-en-scene. A quick recap on the subject: anything in front of the camera is mise-en-scene. This includes the set, the props, the wardrobe, and the actors themselves. There were quite some challenges in this. For instance, filming is forbidden in places like Buckingham Palace and Westminster Abbey, so instead, the production team had to get creative. Ely Cathedral served as a replacement set for Westminster Abbey. For Buckingham Palace, the majority of the sets were filmed in Lancaster House. The others were shot in Rotherham Park and Wilton House. Before the production began for season 3, upgrades were made for the sets resembling Buckingham Palace to look more accurate to the real-life residents. Another department of the production team managed to perfect, or at least tried, according to director Stephen Daldry, was the costume design. Michelle Clapton, the costume designer involved in season 1, expressed that it took multiple people and a period of 6 weeks to recreate a replica resembling the Queen's wedding dress. Interesting fact, the replica of the coronation dress that was used for the show was actually created by the company Swarovski. While the sets and costumes are crucial to replicate to perfection, the last and most important part of the production of The Crown was the cast. Specific actors were replaced every 1 to 2 seasons. For example, Claire Foy was replaced with Olivia Colman after season 2, but some of these replacements were not only done to match the age of the characters as time went on in the series, but to add on the fact that the more mature a character became, the bigger the role they played. To illustrate on this idea, let's have a look at the role of Prince Charles. In seasons 1 and majority of season 2, he is portrayed by Billy Jenkins and then is replaced by Julian Baring for the last 3 episodes of season 2 to match the age growth. The character played a bigger role in the 3rd and 4th season of the series as it took place between 1964 and 1990. Around this time, Prince Charles had received his title as Prince of Wales, began an on-and-off relationship with Camilla Shand, later for her roles, and married Diana Spencer. To again match the age of the character, Baring was replaced with Josh O'Connor for seasons 3 and 4.